So here's a new follow-up to my previous videos, in which I presented some interesting connections that made me form a theory that Shell may be one of the global companies Gevo is negotiating with. According to Gevo, contract deals to a total value of $30 billion are actively being discussed and negotiated with high-quality customers. In the latest Water Tower Research Fireside Chat, Pat was asked to elaborate on Gevo's customer pipeline, and this was his response.
I can't name them. I can't name them. There's a whole nother group of company. Call them energy transition companies, broadly. So these are people who are more on the strategic side. They're trying to figure it out because they know they have to get a position in here. There aren't that many ways to do it. People understand the heifer route. We're the carbohydrate to jet fuel people. And so we have lots of really interesting discussions of people who are in the supply chain, who are in the refining space, who are like Colmar actually does that. And they're also in the supply chain. There's a Trafigura is too, actually. And so I think those people have a different point of view because they know the SAF gets blended. And so if they have access to an airport, they know that SAF is blended. They can sell more of their oil if it's got SAF in it, and they can distribute it because they got a channel to the airport. And then they're already got deals with airlines. So you're going to see this unfold in multiple ways.
The term energy transition refers to the global energy sector's pathway toward transformation from fossil-based to net zero carbon. When I Googled which companies that are highly associated with energy transition, BP and Shell came up as two of the major companies leading the race.
Call them energy transition companies. These are people who are more on the strategic side.
Shell undeniably fits the description of a strategic energy transition company. They have already put a lot of time and resources to set up a serious strategy to achieve their long-term sustainable goal of becoming a net zero emissions energy business by 2050.
Now, to reach net zero emissions, a target by 2050, Shell will need to reduce that to zero. Yes, zero.
And it's not just empty talk. They have already started the process. Shell plans to reduce its refining and chemicals portfolio by more than half to be able to execute the expansion of its renewable and power division. Shell Aviation has one of the world's most extensive fueling networks, supported by a strong supply chain and own refineries.
We have lots of really interesting discussions of people who are in the supply chain, who are in the refining space. They know the SAF gets blended, so if they have access to an airport, they can sell more of their oil if it's got SAF in it, and they can distribute it because they got a channel to the airport, and then they already got deals with airlines.
Wow, Shell definitely fits that description, and they are already working with a wide range of partners to supply increasing amounts of SAF and exploring a number of new technology pathways for SAF production. Could Gevo be one of those? Shell is also a collaborative member of the World Economic Forum's Clean Skies for Tomorrow Coalition. And if you want to dive deeper into that, I recommend you to watch my videos regarding the Global SAF Agenda, Part 1 and 2. In November of 2021, Shell Aviation announced the appointment of John Tushka as president, taking over from Anna Mascolo. If you go to his LinkedIn profile, you find several posts he's made about the importance of SAF and collaborations across the value chain, and this is one of them. He also shared this post, which indicates that Shell has a pipeline of new collaborations.
Call them energy transition companies.
Okay, it might seem a bit far-fetched that Pat was actually referring to Shell in this interview. But when you put this in a context together with all the other pieces of information that I presented in these previous videos, it's intriguing to start connecting the dots.
because the products we're making are in global demand. They're in demand in Europe.
Rotterdam is the largest port in Europe.
Rotterdam is the gateway to Europe.
See by the people piloting on us with ADM, with Chevron and the others.
When you assemble all these small pieces of information that can be found on the internet and listen to all the subtle hints Pat Gruber frequently is teasing us with in the fireside chats, it becomes quite obvious that Shell and Gevo would be a perfect match and that both parties have a lot to gain by landing a strategic partnership. So what do you guys make of all of this? I would love to hear your thoughts, so please share them in the comments section below. And if you appreciate the time and effort I put into making these videos, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. And I appreciate all kind of constructive feedback, including criticism. Keep in mind that my theory put forward in these videos about Gevo and Shell is only speculation. Still, all the facts I present in my videos comes from official sources on the internet, available for everyone who is willing to do their own diligence. That's all I had for now. I hope to see you soon. Until then, bye-bye.